Canada's in the middle of an unprecedented housing crisis. It's one of the top concerns in the country. Everybody, doesn't matter where you live in the country, people are having a hard time finding a place to live or affording basic accommodations if there is anything available. But there's a story that's emerged out of Ottawa this week that I think you need to know about. And nobody's really put all of this together yet. So I want to break down for you what the Liberal government is saying about Canada's immigration system right now. There's a lot of things that's happened this week, and I've put together an explainer piece for you. I'm going to break it down in this video. But before I get into it, I have to underscore how important it is to get this information out under Justin Trudeau's censorship bills, C-18, C-11, and now C-63. So there's a link in the comments. In the comments or in the video description, if you're watching this on YouTube, is an explainer piece. It has all of the links to all of the articles that I'm going to mention in this video so you can see it for yourself. If you click subscribe on that, it allows me to directly communicate with you and skip Justin Trudeau's censorship bans. This is the only way I can communicate with you. It's free to subscribe. Please do that. Also, please share this video and please click subscribe if you're watching on YouTube. So what happened this week? We're in the middle of a housing crisis. And yesterday, actually it was 2 days ago now, Justin Trudeau's immigration minister gave this long interview in the Toronto Star. And we all know that Canada's immigration system is broken. This isn't my words. These are words of Canada's top economists, experts. They've been talking about this for months, years. But Justin Trudeau's immigration minister went in the Toronto Star and said the following. He blamed the following group for Canada's immigration system failure. He actually pointed the finger at his own government. He said, he called the immigration system a system that lacks rigor and discipline. Well, no kidding. And he also said it was an unbridled backdoor entry system. He's also called the immigration system as out of control. These comments, the current immigration minister, Mark Miller, comes on the heels of his predecessor, Sean Fraser, who failed upwards into the housing file. And earlier this year, Mr. Fraser actually blamed the immigrants that he brought in to Canada under his programs for Canada's housing crisis. I want to be very clear. The only people Canadians, longtime citizens or newcomers alike, should be blaming for the housing crisis and for Canada's problematic immigration system is the Liberal government. So here you've got Mark Miller, the current immigration minister, pointing a finger at his own government, and I'm gonna get to this in a second, and then earlier, his predecessor going, well, we have a housing crisis, you know, ascribing motive, and well, it's like, you know, he's pointing the finger at immigrants that he brought in under his own programs, and it's like, guys, the call is coming from inside the house, right? So in this article that's in the link in the comments, please click subscribe, please read through it. I've got all of these links so you can read this for yourself. I'm not making this up. Like, it's literally in the Toronto Star, so you can read through it there. But what they fail to understand, Mark Miller, is like, both of these guys have been in this government for 9 years. They sat quietly and idly by while the government ignored warning signs. Like, literally, they ignored warning signs from their own department officials saying that Canada's housing stock was not matching the immigration levels in the country. They just ignored that, right? And they leaned into these policies. So it's really rich for them today to be doing the blame game, either pointing it at other people in the ministry. I think that Mark Miller's doing that just to put political distance between himself and the dumpster fire left from his predecessors. I don't think he actually cares about solving the problem. If he did, he would have been putting forward solutions by now, right? This is all just politics to him. But at the end of the day, they're blaming people instead of taking action. Here's the thing. I've got a link to this in the article, the link's in the comments again as well. There was a really alarming study that was a poll that came out this month that showed that 60% of Canadians now have questions about whether or not immigration is in the best interest of the country. And I have to tell you, that sentiment was not there under the former Conservative government. This is a sentiment that has only come into play under this Liberal government. Immigration has been a net benefit to Canada over the years. And many of you who are watching this now, I know you feel the same way. The problem occurred was when the Liberal government in Miller's own words, in the immigration minister's own words, let the system get out of control and didn't match immigration levels to the capacity for Canada's economic and social fabric to successfully integrate newcomers into our country, particularly housing. You know, many of my constituents are newcomers to Canada. They're wonderful people. They're building businesses. They're creating jobs. However, they are experiencing the same inflationary pressures and pressures to find people, places to live that everybody in Canada is, no matter if they were born here, if they immigrated, or when they immigrated. So I know what the Liberals are going to try and do with this. The reason why they're playing the blame game is they want all of us to be looking at each other as opposed to who created the problem. It's not people who chose to come to Canada's problem that the Liberals had these policies that did not match immigration levels to, let's say, housing numbers. It's not their fault. No, it's whose fault is it? It's the Liberal government's fault. So the next time somebody, you know, you hear something like this, or somebody talks about, you know, temporary resident visas or whatnot, and people are talking about this, the Liberals want us to be pointing fingers at each other, right? Because that deflects from their inability to bring the situation to a point where people can live a successful life in Canada. So we can't allow that to happen, right? We can't allow what the narrative that Mark Miller is putting in the Toronto Star, or what Sean Fraser was saying, that it's immigrants' fault. We can't let the blame be placed there, because that is going to do what, guys? It's going to rip our social fabric apart. That's exactly what the Liberals want to have happen here, because they don't want to fix this problem, because they can't, because they don't have the capacity to do it. They don't have the political will to do it. They don't have the expertise to do it. So don't let that happen. We can't let that happen. The last thing that I want to draw your attention to on this issue is, this is something that I've been talking about for years. I served as the Conservative Party's immigration critic for over 5 years. And the link that's in there's a link in the comment. It's got my article on it. At the very end of the article, I include a link to a press conference that I gave in 2018 that talked about the need, in order to ensure that, you know, people coming to Canada have a successful experience, and that, you know, that consensus for immigration that existed under a former Conservative government existed, that it continued to succeed. I did this press conference where I talked about the need to match Canada's immigration levels to our capacity to integrate. You know, the Liberals have spent the last 9 years demonizing anybody who talked about immigration in a positive way, but said, hey, there are systemic failures in our system right now, like the fact that, again, this was reported this month, the link is in the article that's in the comments, it was leaked that the government is looking at having to buy hotels to house refugees that are in years, sometimes over a decade long claim review processes. That's not right. That's not fair to anybody. It's not fair to Canadian taxpayers, and it's not fair to the refugees that come to Canada, right? Right? So, you know, guys, the Liberals want us to point fingers at each other. That's what they're doing right now. We can't let that we can't allow that to happen. So this is such an important issue, because Canada, actually, what makes us unique and what's made us unique for so many years is that we are a country of people from around the world. For decades, we have lived in peace and harmony with each other. We've built businesses together. Our families intermarry. We have family dinners together, right? That's part of who and what we are as Canadians. But the Liberals have perverted that by breaking our system, by degrading, you know, like some of our economic institutions, and we can't allow that to happen. So I want you to read the article. Again, I think this is a really important piece for everybody in Canada to read, just to understand exactly what the Liberals are doing with this file. And I need you to share this video and click subscribe. I try to do these analysis pieces for you so that you understand what I see as a legislator in Canada, and understand how important it is to not let the Liberals fool you with this type of divisive politics, this sort of blame game. We have to hold them to account. It doesn't matter how you vote. What's happening here is wrong. And the people who are causing this problem, the only people that are causing this problem, are the Liberal caucus and the Liberal cabinet, all of them, and Justin Trudeau, who have perpetuated this problem for years. So share this video. Please click subscribe to the article that's on the link in the comments. please click subscribe to this channel so that I can come to you with more information. And just know that this sort of disgusting politics is the sign of a desperate, weak government that has lost the moral authority to govern. Working hard for you. Have a great day.